once mighty army of Azeroth lay among the blackened and charred remains of Stormwind Keep. Those that escaped fled across the Great Sea, bringing tales of the suffering they had faced at the hands of the Orcish hordes. Eager to engage in battle once again, the Orcs constructed ships of war to bear them across the Great Sea. The Orcish warriors yearned for the sounds of battle to fill the air and looked to the far horizon for new blood to spill. Using the weapons forged by their new allies, the humans made haste to prepare for the onslaught. While dwarven cannon were being loaded, others armed themselves with elven steel and mail. United in arms with new allies against a common foe, mankind stands at the shores of destiny and awaits the coming of the Tides of Darkness.
Staging area for Horde troops. You are to retake Dun Mordra and then bring your forces to bear against Strongguard's nearby island citadel of Tol Barad. Has sent word that the Ogre Mage Cho'Gall, chieftain of the Twilight's Hammer Clan, is personally inspecting the refinery at Grim Batal. Cho'Gall and his convoy will be traveling through the Badlands of Cosmodan, and an ambush by Strongguard warriors is expected. The War Chief expects you to safeguard Cho'Gall and his minions through this region. Should he die, your life will be forfeit as well. Reports that the Cosmodan refineries are well maintained and fulfilling their quotas. The Horde will now have more than enough oil to mount a fierce campaign in the lands far to the north. Only the troublesome human defenders of Strongguard remain to be dealt with before sending the Horde on its next sojourn. The human fleet has captured a group of our transports just south of Strongguard. Recapture these vessels and then lay waste to their capital. Located a mysterious elven artifact near the keep of Cardero. This huge, monolithic runestone is guarded by a human castle on the small island located in the middle of Daromir Lake. You must destroy the forces that guard this relic and gain control of the runestone for use by the Horde. Of the Elven Runestone, Gul'dan has been able to warp the power it contains to mutate an entire legion of his loyal and ruthless ogres into wielders of arcane magics. Along with this transformation, these ogre magi have been granted deadly magics and a malicious cunning rivaling that of Gul'dan himself. You are to employ the Ogre Magi in the creation and defense of a fortress at the mouth of Tears Bay, cutting off the human supply lines into Quel'Thalas. Tholm, the chief source of Alliance oil in the north, is preparing to deliver massive amounts of oil to the kingdoms in western Lordaeron. You must sabotage their refineries and platforms to halt this shipment. Once Strathom's ability to gather and process oil is destroyed, proceed to crush any and all resistance offered by the Alliance. Destruction of Strathom, the Alliance supply lines to Quel'Thalas have been severed. Only a handful of human and elven defenders remain to safeguard the ancient elf kingdom from the onslaught of the Horde. The enchanted domain of the elves has inspired Gul'dan to unleash his most perverted creation, the Death Knights. Born from the corpses of the fallen Knights of Azeroth, these once proud defenders of humanity now serve the Horde in a blasphemous state of eternal undeath, conjuring dark spells of necromantic horror upon their terrified foes. These Death Knights seek to unleash their wrath upon any foolish enough to stand in their way. Traitor under the direction of Doom reports that Gul'dan has indeed raised volcanic islands from the ocean floor and thus has opened a hidden vault. While it is unknown what the Great Warlock has released from this tomb, the War Chief has issued this command: destroy the renegade clans and return with the head of Gul'dan. Judgment is close at hand as the orcish hordes stand ready to sweep across this domain like a pestilence and seize the capital of Lordaeron. Standing vigilant above the plains like the descending arm of twilight itself is the violet citadel of Dalaran. The citadel, serving as sanctum and haven to the mages of Lordaeron, is the last barrier between the orcs and their subjugation of humanity. Manifested in the combined magical prowess of all mages within the Alliance, this place must fall for the Horde to conquer Lordaeron. Fortunately, Orgrim Doomhammer has saved his greatest weapon, ready to unleash it upon the unsuspecting Alliance at just this moment. Dragons.
Of Lordaeron's capital, looming before you in the distance. The proud, defiant armies of the Alliance stand resolute in their final, fleeting moments. All that remains is the shrill, clarion call to battle and the fulfillment of our destiny. The tides of darkness are now at hand.
Station of Warlord, thus giving you power and the command of your own clan. The Alliance has finally been crushed, with all those surviving being slain and cremated as is dictated by the rituals. At long last, Azeroth and all of its lands belong to the thunderous force known to those foolish enough to stand in its way as the Horde.
Position as regional commander of the Southern Defense Forces, Lord Terranus commands that you raise an outpost in the Hillsbrad foothills. It is rumored that orcish marauders have been raiding coastal towns in the area, but whether these attacks are part of a greater Horde offensive is as yet unknown. Your outpost is to provide food and information for Alliance troops, and as such, should be a community consisting of at least 4 farms. You must also construct a barracks in order to safeguard the Hillsbrad operation. Mysterious elves of Silvermoon have sent a contingent of archers south to survey the supposed orcish threat for themselves. Our spies report that shortly after passing through the Alteric grasslands, the elves were ambushed by Horde troops. It is believed that these elves are now being held in a small prison camp near the northwest region of Terran Mill. Lord Terranus, fervently hoping to enlist the elves into the Alliance, has asked that you search for the missing warriors and deliver them to safety. The elves have sent a cadre of archers to assist in your quest. You will also be provided with plans to construct an elven lumber mill and the Sylvan craftsmen to operate it. Safe return of the elves from the loathsome clutches of the orcs, the Council of Silvermoon has resolved to combine the armies of Quel'Thalas with those of the Alliance of Lordaeron. As a show of their support, a mighty fleet of elven destroyers have been sent to help safeguard the Lordaeron mainland. preparation for the arrival of these ships, Dalen Proudmoore, Lord of Kul Tiras and Grand Admiral of the Lordaeron Fleet, has ordered that you begin the construction of naval facilities near the township of South Shore. There is some suspicion that the Horde has constructed a secret base near the mainland, so it is imperative that you begin building your defense with haste. Establish some order in the region with a display of naval power. Admiral Proudmoore advises that the time has come to search out the secret lair of the orcs. Scouts report that this base is located somewhere within the Zuldaer region of the Channel Islands, just southeast of Hillsbrad. Lordaeron artificers have completed designs for a foundry. With this new innovation, you will be able to construct transport ships that can ferry your troops across large bodies of water. These vessels should provide great assistance in the completion of your task. Impressed with your victories against the Horde and the destruction of the Zuldaer base, the High Command has decided to dispatch you and your troops to the main battleground. The forces of Stromgard and Kul Tiras are stationed along the northern border of Cosmodan, fighting to keep the orcs from advancing into southern Lordaeron. An orcish outpost, nestled near the ruins of the ancient dwarven city of Dun Modra, has repeatedly beaten back Alliance troops and ravaged the surrounding farmlands. You must reclaim the nearby island keep at Tol Barad and then launch an attack upon the outpost. In their defeat at Dun Modra, the orcs were forced to retreat south across the Fandol Valley to a secondary outpost at Dun Algarz. Lord Lothar, hoping to push the orcs even further back into Cosmodan, has ordered that you destroy this newly discovered encampment. To aid you in your mission, you will be able to employ knights who are eager to engage the Horde in glorious battle. Their scouts report that they have located Grim Batal, the primary base of the Horde's refinery operations in Cosmodan. Seeing a chance to strike a decisive blow against the Horde, Lord Lothar has ordered that you infiltrate Grim Batal and put an end to all orcish activity there. Once Grim Batal has been destroyed, Lothar believes that the orcs will have no further use for Cosmodan, thus pulling their forces back to the mainland of Azeroth. Victory could secure the shores of Lordaeron and greatly impede the Horde offensive. Still hangs over the head of the Alliance. Lord Lothar has stationed your troops in the Northlands to protect the borders of Quel'Thalas. Troubles have arisen in the township of Tyr's Hand, with the local peasant population in a state of minor revolt. You must quell this uprising and then summon the Knights of the Silver Hand to watch over the populace. To maintain order in the region, you must search out all of the Horde forces in the area and destroy them. Paladins keeping vigilant watch over the Northlands, the Archbishop's assistant, Uther Lightbringer of Lordaeron, has come to offer comfort to those who are suffering the misfortunes of war. Lord Lothar has entrusted you with the protection of the Paladin's commander and his entourage as they travel to the island township of Cair Daro. At Cair Daro, a number of renegade Altarach soldiers were captured. crew of Altarak sailors were also caught assisting the Horde during the battle and have been placed under close guard. Under the edict of Lord Lothar, you are to restrain the prisoners until they can be escorted to the capital of Lordaeron for interrogation. Lothar sends word that the Alliance has been betrayed. Lord Perrinold, sovereign ruler of Altarak, has been working with the Horde since the beginning of the war. It was Perrinold who provided the Orcs with the routes of the Elven Strike Force passing through Terran Mill. The rebellion at Tyr's Hand was also started by Altarak spies in hope of concealing the Orcish mining facility located there. The High Command has decreed that the nation of Altarak has committed treason against the Alliance and their union with the Orcish hordes must be broken. You must free those unjustly held by Perrinold and enlist their aid in launching an attack against Altarak's capital. Located the Horde's main naval base near Crestfall. Proudmoore believes that the Orcs plan to launch the remainder of their armada and retreat to the mainland of Azeroth. Lord Lothar has ordered that you destroy the base at Crestfall before the fleet can escape. Remnants of the routed Orcish fleet have managed to reach the northern shores of Azeroth. Admiral Proudmoore believes that the Horde will attempt to reinforce their main fortress at Blackrock Spire. Leading a large strike force of Lordaeron troops, Lord Lothar was sent to attempt a parley with the Orcish chieftain, Orgrim Doomhammer. No reports have been heard in days. Assuming the worst, Admiral Proudmoore and King Terranus agree that it falls upon you to stage a final siege upon Blackrock Spire. The feral dwarves of the Northaeron Wildlands have offered the service of their griffin riders to assist in the decimation of the foul orcs that have desecrated their homeland and slain the leader of the Alliance forces. Orcs have been driven from the Northlands as the hulking remains of Blackrock Spire lay silent amongst the freed lands of Azeroth. The battered remains of the once mighty Horde have rallied to protect their last bastion of hope. The Great Portal. With Lord Lothar dead, you have been given the duty of leading the forces of Lordaeron to ultimate victory over the Horde. A victory that lies with the destruction of the Great Portal itself. Over the tattered remnants of the once mighty Orcish hordes. Those Orcs that survived the conflict have fled to the northeast in hopes of escaping your vengeance. You allow them their reprieve, knowing that the power of the Horde has been forever broken and that the lands of Azeroth belong to its native sons and daughters once again.